for a team that has been accustomed this year to getting so much bad news, it's always refreshing when we actually get some good. YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And in this video, Brandon Williams, Justin Matabike, and Justin Houston are officially back. After being placed on the COVID-19 list last week, after Jalen Ferguson tested positive and they were deemed close contacts, they are back and expected to all go this week. Well, they still have to practice, of course, but they're back. Jalen Ferguson is not back yet, but those guys are. And what that means to the Ravens, it's a lot. But before we get into it, I got to say that I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And don't let anybody throw you off your game, especially somebody whose opinion of you is insignificant. I gotta admit, I let somebody throw me off for a little bit yesterday. Well, it was only for a couple of minutes, but that was a couple of minutes where I was just off for a little bit. And their opinion, it really doesn't even matter. And it shouldn't have even mattered even for those couple of minutes. But I let it matter for those couple of minutes. So that's on me. But I appreciate y'all. I appreciate you all's positivity. 99% of y'all for Team Keep It Clean, y'all positive. And again, y'all are positive whether we agree or disagree. Now, I 100%, because if somebody is negative even when we disagree, then they not really Team Keep It Clean, because that's not what we about, man. But anyway, I love y'all, and I appreciate y'all. So, back to the news. Brandon Williams, he's back, and he was missed a lot last week. Well, Brandon Williams, we just know. We always know when he's not out there because it shows. So when he's not out there for an entire game, oh yeah, it's we feel it, we see it, we understand it. When we like, oh my goodness, we need 98 more than ever, because the run defense, they suffer big time. They suffer so much, and it's just clear as day. Brandon Williams is he's the anchor of this run defense. He makes the run defense that much better. He makes guys around him, he makes their job easier, because he takes on all these blockers. He's a force. And again, I always say, if people ask me, oh, who's the most underrated Ravens player? Brandon Williams. Or who's the most underappreciated Ravens player? Brandon Williams. It's him all day, every day. But he's back. Him back is huge. He's a first and second down lineman. He's not a third down. Well, when third down is a passing down, he's not a passing down defensive lineman. No, that's not him. But first and second down on a run defense, yeah, that's your guy. So it's going to be nice having him back, especially against these Broncos, man. It's going to be really nice. Justin Matabike, he has been somebody who's had an impact both on run and pass defense, because he's somebody who, again, we saw him coming along strong toward the end of last year. And then this year, he's been very, very active. They've been using him a lot. They we knew they really valued Justin Matabike a lot. And I always tell this story with Justin Matabike because it's just so significant to me, because of last year. Last year when he got hurt, the Ravens could have put him on IR, and they could have been like, you know what, he's going to miss three games, but they didn't. And I think he was out like the first two games, and I think he came back week three. But the fact that they kept a rookie spot on the active roster instead of putting him on IR temporarily and giving that spot to somebody else, that just said a lot to me about Justin Matabike. And we saw throughout the season, especially toward the end of the season, we saw exactly why they felt that way. And then, of course, we've been seeing it this season too. Justin Matabike is a force. He is a disruptive player. And he is in such a good situation because we all expect him to take over. Calais Campbell, he ain't getting no younger. Brandon Williams, he ain't getting no younger. Pernell McPhee, he ain't getting no younger. Justin Matabike, somebody who can bring it from the interior, even the exterior as well. He's somebody that you can move around. We expect him to take over for those guys soon enough. And Derek Wolfe also ain't getting no younger. So, the position that he's in learning from a Calais Campbell, learning from a Brandon Williams, and taking everything, soaking in all that knowledge while gaining a lot of experience at the same time, is great for him. So when he does end up taking over probably next year, that he's not going in blindly like, oh man, what am I supposed to do? No, he's got guys showing him the ropes right now, so that'll help in the future. But he's somebody that we missed as well. Jared Goff, yeah, I think Tavon Young sacked him, Chuck Clark sacked him and whatnot, but was Jared Goff getting consistently pressured? No, especially in that second half. Second half was just, they made adjustments. They adjusted to our defense and just made the game very stressful. There were some other reasons why the game was very stressful, but we didn't need to talk about those no more. So Justin Madubuike, welcome back. And then last but not least, Justin Houston. Justin Houston, veteran guy, Yoda guy. I mean, you could put the title of defensive coordinator on his job title right now, too, with him giving wing tips on stuff to do, and that stuff worked. But again, the pass rush, we were missing that, especially the second half against the Lions on Sunday. So him being out, him being back, it helps a lot, especially because timing is everything. Dalen Hayes, although it was his first game, so he hadn't played the previous two games, he was out there for a little bit, then boom, now he's out for at least three games. He didn't even finish the game the other day. So we down a pass rusher. Tyus Bowser, he's been a little quiet this season so far. Almost made a play the other day, though, which was good. We wish he would have made the play, but hey, that's why he plays defense, because he ain't got hands like that. So that's cool. And better that he dropped that would-be interception rather than him allowing it to go to a Detroit Lions player's hands. So there's that. You can look at the negative, but you got to look at the positive, too. Try to look at it from both ways. But Justin Houston, with this pass rush, he helps. He helps. Because we've been seeing it for the past all 3 weeks, really, that this team has been, because these games, we've been gassed from the games, but the team has definitely been gassed in these games. So when you're down so much depth, it just makes everybody that much more tired. It's like, oh man, we really missing those guys. Because Jelly had to play that much more. The guy they called up from the practice squad, McKenzie, is it Isaiah McKenzie, I think? I don't remember off the top of my head. But those guys, Calais Campbell, of course, those guys had to put in that much more. But now we got our guys back. So it just, this is, it's big, man. So I know there was somebody, and it was a good point. There was somebody who made a comment on a video before the game, and they were like, I think a lot of people are undervaluing just how big of a loss all these guys were. And some of us did. Not even that some of us undervalued how big of a loss it was. I think that we just felt like, all right, well, if this is going to happen, the timing of it is not good, but this is a better timing than it happening later against a better team, so to speak. Because since it was the Lions, then a lot of us were like, oh, okay, so we should be all right. We should be okay. Since it was against the Lions. But we saw that, and again, wasn't because of the defense. The Lions, they hung around. The defense actually, they were doing pretty good in that first half. It was just the offense that they let us down. They let the team down. And that kept the game close. So these guys being out, that impact felt it even more. So, but it's nice that they're back now. Again, of course, Jalen Ferguson, he's not back yet. So we'll see how long it takes for him to get back. And yeah, Ravens practices today should start actually in a little bit. But y'all have a good day. Y'all have a really great day. Do your thing. Keep going. Keep pushing. Just don't let nobody rock you off, man. Or knock you off or whatever. Don't let nobody knock you off. I appreciate y'all. Thank you for always listening. Thank you for just making this thing a part of your lives, man. Thank you for being willing to give me the chance to be part of you all's lives. With talking about Ravens, talking about whatever in the NFL. I appreciate that opportunity. So I love y'all. And like Brandon Williams, Justin Matabike, and Justin Houston no longer are, I'm out.